Entonces, me. Excuse me. Excuse me. By the way, this is K Divine Collections. No hair touches this scalp, period, if it's not K Divine Collections. I'm just waiting for her to come out with some glueless wigs. And then your girl is set. Welcome back to my channel. So today I have a full face review for you guys. That's reviewing the September Ipsy Glam box. So if you guys are interested, before we start this video, join the family and subscribe that red button. El botón rojo ahí mismo que tú ves que dice subscribe, suscribe. Dale un click and click subscribe. Hay una campanita allá abajo también. Dale a la campanita, turn on the bell. So the bell notifies you every single time I upload a video. La campanita lo que te notifica cada vez que yo subo un video. Y también dejen un comentario si ustedes quieren que yo haga un video, qué sé yo, en otra cosa que no sea maquillaje. Dame idea. So leave a comment down below if you want me to do some other videos besides makeup. Just give me some ideas. But yeah, let's just hop right into this video. Vamos a comenzar este video. And yeah, no te olvides, dale like. Dale like, no te olvides. Don't forget to subscribe. No te olvides suscribirte. Y no te olvides darle la campanita. Don't forget to hit the bell. Let's hop right into this video.
Poppin', shippin' only cause you know you poppin', yeah. You got it, girl, you got it. You got it.
Little baby and I'm back and I'm working.
What's up YouTube? So I'm back and today I have a full face, a first impression. So I'm gonna actually I'm gonna use most of the items from this Ipsy box. So this is the Ipsy monthly subscription, and as if you guys don't know, I think I spoke about Ipsy before on my channel, but basically Ipsy is a monthly subscription box. I first started off with Ipsy years ago using just the $10 a month subscription, where they bring you five like travel size deluxe samples so you can try out, and they also came with a cute little makeup bag to store them in. But now we have the Ipsy Glam, what is it called? I think it's the Glam Plus, something like that. But yeah, it comes in this big box. So if you guys remember, the Ipsy box was way smaller, and if you guys have the BoxyCharm monthly subscription, this one is completely different. But basically I'm gonna do a full face using the products that I received in this box. And the first product that we have is the Wonder Beauty eyebrow, and I did try anything else in the box. I have not tried, but I did use this Wonder Beauty pencil, brow pencil, because I'm more of a pomade type of girl, but I needed a pencil to get up and go. Basically, to speed up the process when I'm getting ready for work, because that's the only time I really wear makeup consistently. So it's this Wonder Beauty Brow Pencil. And I believe, let me see if this has a shade here, because I'm so horrible. Throw away the box. So it's the shade Dark Brown, and this is the Frame Your Face Micro Brow Pencil. So this is it. What it is, and this is what I'm going to be using to do my brows today. This is the pamphlet that came in this month's box. So here it says, find your light. September is all about new paths and possibilities. So whether it's going all out with a bold new lip shade or masking at home to recharge from within, take a moment to rediscover your guiding north star. Where will it lead you? Discover yourself. And then on the back, it says, Ipsy, your Glam Bag Plus just got better. Starting with your October Glam Bag Plus, enjoy these new features. So basically, it just tells you the new features that they have coming up for their next box in October. You can add on. So basically, like, they have some products that are discounted. So, like, let's say they can throw in a NARS blush. You could get a full size for $20, for example, or a deluxe sample size for $10. So they have the option where you can add those add-ons just at a set price, and then they can ship it to you with your Glam box. So that is really, really dope. Well, since I already mentioned the brow pencil, this is the Wonder Beauty Frame Your Face Micro Brow Pencil in Dark Brown. And it says, it's founded by a jet-setting mother and supermodel duo. This team crafts low-fuss formulas that deliver high-impact looks. This brow-boosting tool with an ultra-precise pencil tip on one end and a spoolie on the other gives you smear-proof strokes with a natural-looking finish. It's valued at $21, so this does retail for $21. And they also have a tip for every item that's in the box. So it says, tip, brush eyebrow hairs vertically, then use this pencil to draw short strokes and fill in sparse areas. So this is for the first product. And I guess I'm gonna just apply and read as I go for everything that I use. The only thing that I won't use is a mask that's here. I should actually use a mask, huh? But I'm trying to make this quick and simple, y'all. So the mask that comes in here, let me go grab it real quick. Okay, so the mask that actually comes in the box is this one, and it's called the I Do Care Disco Kit and Illuminating Diamond Peel Off Mask. So this says it's an illuminous, super satisfying peel off formula mask from the I Do Care K Beauty line. Revitalizes skin on all fronts. It moisturizes, calms, exfoliates, and brightens. Diamond powder boosts elasticity, while rice bran extract packs in the antioxidant. This does retail for $23, and it says the tip is to apply a generous layer of this mask with fingers and let it dry completely to ensure it peels off in one piece, which is the best part, as emphasized. So that's the mask. So before I move in and tell you guys any other products that we have, I'm just gonna go ahead and do my brows with the Wonder Beauty brow pencils I mentioned. Alright, so my eyebrows look real crazy. Ooh, child. Real crazy. So, this pencil is a little too, it's a little too soft for my liking. So, as you can see, you can build up the color. I don't know. You can build up the color. This is the color of the soft brown. But I'm gonna go ahead and clean up my eyebrows because it looks a hot mess, so that we could look a little put together. Now that I look a little crazy, I'm gonna actually use that same concealer to prep my eyes. So as crazy as I look, don't mind. I'm gonna look good at that. So the next product that I have here, you probably seen it already, you probably peeped it, but when I was doing my brows, I was using the Nomad Cosmetics mirror. So is this beautiful eyeshadow palette. It said it's Nomad Cosmetics Berlin Underground Intense Eyeshadow Palette, and it says it's inspired by Berlin's rebellious 90s counterculture. This 15 shade palette features metallic, matte, and dual chrome hues like distressed black, burnt orange, and snake skin green. Hemp seed oil nourishes lids with a buttery soft feel and serious color payoff. And then the tip is use these shadows dry for subtle shading and everyday looks, or wet for dramatic high impact shimmer. So let's open this up. It retails for $37. So this is what the front looks like. So it just says Nomad, Berlin Underground. And then the back, same thing. It says Nomad Intense Eyeshadow, designed in Germany. And then when you open it up, this is what it looks like. Ooh. These colors are beautiful. Look at that. Look at that. So, the only thing is, oh, okay, it has an orange. Oh, all right. So, most of them are shimmers. I love me some mattes. So, that's a little disappointing, but these shimmers are gorgeous. So, what I'm going to do, I'm going to use Orange Strap, this shade. And I'm gonna use that as my transition color because I think that's the only matte shade I have in here. So yeah, we're gonna do that. We're not gonna do nothing crazy. I'm gonna get this big fluffy brush, which is the Morphe E27. And I'm just gonna pat this on. For the next shade, there are beautiful shades in this palette. Like, oh my god, like gorgeous shades. And I really feel like the camera is really not doing it any justice, but these are basically emerald, there you go, like emerald looking shades. I love shades like that. So again, I don't want to do nothing too crazy, but if you guys are interested and you guys are loving these shades as much as I am, let me know and I can do a separate tutorial with a bomb ass look, because these colors are bomb. So Hansa is calling my name, is this dark color right here. I'm gonna go in with this fluffy brush. This is a short shading brush from Farrah, and let's see how it picks up. Oh, it picks up a good amount on brushes. Let me see. Oh wow, could y'all see this on camera? And to think I was gonna give this palette away. So I'm gonna layer shimmers on. This is a beautiful bronze palette. I mean shade. This is just bomb. Oh, and this is, mind you y'all, this is on a dry brush. I did not spray this brush at all, so imagine if I were to spray it for an extra pop. So I'm gonna go in with, even though this gold is screwing my name, I'm gonna go with KO Stage, which is this green-ish shade. I'm gonna use that same brush, and I want to put this right in the center, kind of like to give me a halo effect. Let me see. Oh yes, just for additional brightening. Oh my god, I love this palette. I'm gonna go in with Club Nacht. This shade, this is the black, and the palette has a little bit of shimmer in it. Yo, these shades are really pigmented. I'm gonna put this in the outer corner just a little bit and to give it some dimension. I've been told que ustedes quieren que yo hable español. No es que yo no quiero hablar español, pero yo no sé, como que hay alguna cosa que me dan brega decir. Y no porque yo no hablo el idioma, pero es que es demasiado detalle. Pero si ustedes quieren esto en español también, me avisan. Lo pongo bilingual, however you want. So, let me know if you guys want videos en español. Because I have a couple people already request Spanish videos, so. Yeah. So I'm gonna go back into this big fluffy brush. I'm just gonna swirl it, because I don't want this to go anywhere else. By the way guys, it came in this box. So in the back, it actually, oh, okay. So I missed out a very important detail. So it comes with this in the back. So it tells you intense eyeshadow formulated with extra fine pigments for a fierce color payoff. The same thing infused with hemp seed oil to help energize and nourish the skin. 15 alternative shades inspired by the rebellious underground culture of Berlin before and after the wall. That's exactly what it was giving me. It gives me like old cultural Jesus vibe. I don't know. It really does. But it shows this. It's a breakdown of the colors. Very beautiful. I feel like this is very beautiful because it's trying to tell a story, and these colors, like, yo, I did not think I was gonna like this palette as much as I do, and this palette is bomb. And of course, it's by Ipsy, so if you guys are interested in purchasing this palette, you can find it on their site. Now I'm gonna move on to my foundation. So from Ciate London, we have an extraordinary translucent powder, y'all. So I'm excited for this because I'm always excited for a new powder. So this says, this ultra blendable translucent powder from formula driven innovators Ciate London is finely milled magic. It glides over makeup for a crease free soft focus finish and locks your look in all day, which is truly extraordinary. She sounds super promising. So let's see. It says, tip, to bake and set areas with concealer, pack on a generous amount of this translucent powder over your concealer and leave on for 3 to 5 minutes before sweeping off the excess. So next I'm gonna do that and not look cakey. She sounds promising, but I don't know if I wanna bake today. Maybe we should bake just to put it to the test, right? So we're gonna go ahead and open up. Oh, and then this retails for $22. So let's open her up. Let's see what she looks like. Also, she's cute. She's cute. I hope she's flash friendly. So it comes with the same little dispenser. I smell everything. I smell my food too. My mom was always yelling at me about that. So she's white. Like, if you're a deep skin tone, you might want to skip out. Let's see, because I am not even that dark, and I don't gravitate towards shit like this because it's scary. So I'm going to grab a little bit on my brush, and I'm going to fluff some off first, and then we're going to set. She instantly looked like she smoothed out my skin. So far, so good. Did I find a new favorite powder? I think I did. Hold on. Let me finish my face. Let me not get ahead of myself. Let's bake a little bit. We're gonna bake. We're gonna really put her to the test. Grab a generous amount. That's taupe. And bake. It's very smoothing, like, oh my God. She's okay. All right, so I'm actually gonna dust this off right away because I don't like letting them sit for too long. So I'm gonna grab the same foundation brush that I used earlier and pat this off. I look snatched. Okay, hold on. So far, I like the powder, but see this little white situation? I just wish it was a little more. I just wish it was like tinted, bro. Like, and the last product that we have in this Ipsy box is this Ofra Cosmetics Madison Miller Squad Palette. So it says, multitaskers rejoice. This three-piece palette collab from Ofra Cosmetics and content creator Madison Miller, a new mama, is all about that go glow. Highly pigmented and a clinch to blend, this rosy combo of blush and highlighter creates a lit from within look in mere minutes. Tip, make the most of your palette by dipping a wet brush into pigments to use as eyeshadow. I don't have a powder, like a face powder, but I definitely want to go with a face powder of my skin tone. Just to tone this down a little bit. Let me see, this is the Ofra palette. It's from Madison Miller. Okay, and it's a beautiful, oh my God, like blush and two highlights. This is definitely a wearable blush, and I don't wear blush, but this is something I would wear. And two highlight shades. Let's see what they look like. So the first one is the more goldy shade. Let me swatch them here. But this is the goldy shade, and this is the more pinky shade. They look very, very similar. Not the most pigmented. Honestly, I had way better. Get a regular brush. I'm gonna try to dust this off somewhere because I feel like for the sake of this video, I shouldn't go over top with a powder. All right, so I'm gonna go in with this brush. This is a Sephora brush. This is a highlight brush, and I'm gonna use it as my blush brush. I'm gonna dip it into that pink shade in the middle and smile. Oh, that's okay. Smile. So I didn't bronze my face. I was wondering why I look so funny. Okay, so. This is a cute blush. I normally don't go for blush, but this is very pretty. Very pink, subtle flush of color. Before I finish my face, because I definitely have to grab a bronzer, I'm gonna go back into that beautiful eyeshadow palette that has got me shook. Go back into orange strawberry, that color, and put it underneath. She's pretty. So I'm like, why is it so dark? So this still has the black shade underneath, but that's fine because I was gonna go in that with that anyway. So you could have just went in with whatever you had remaining of that brush. I'm gonna quickly bronze up my face, bring more color into my face. So before I do that, I'm gonna grab this powder. It's more like in my skin tone, in the shade 332 from Maybelline Fit Me. Same foundation brush, because why not? And I'm just gonna sweep like top over top of that. Top over top of that. And then I'm gonna go in with my Hoola bronzer. I'm gonna mix my bronzer. I'm gonna use the Hoola one, and for extra depth, I'm gonna use 360 from Maybelline Fit Me. That might be enough. Ooh. It's just, I'll leave that pill on camera. Back into that Ofra palette. And I wanna use the gold shade. I'm gonna use the Real Techniques setting brush, I believe it is. One of my favorite brushes. And I'm gonna go into this gold shade, as I mentioned. Just go a little ham and smile. Oh freak, I underestimated the heck out of this. Wow. I did not expect this pigment. I'm gonna throw on a quick lip, maybe some mascara, and I'll be right back. So this is the finished look with the review. Basically the whole Ipsy box that I received. It is a full face of first impressions. Every single item I used, minus the lips and the mascara, was brand new. I've never used it before except the Wonder Beauty brow pencil that I did mention that I did try out. But other than that, everything is bomb. From my Ipsy box, yo, this had me shook. And the reason being, like, look how pretty is a natural, not natural, but pretty and subtle this makeup eye look is. I did not expect this to be as pigmented as they are. And mind you, I did not wet my brush. Imagine if I sprayed my brush with Fix Plus or whatever the case may be. This is bomb. I loved the powder, although it is white, as I mentioned. It's not gonna be color girl friendly, so I would recommend mixing it with maybe another loose powder that you have. Me personally, I had to go over top of it with a powder my skin tone so it can look appealing, because it was a little too bright for my liking. I don't like my under eyes that bright, but this is bomb. I just feel like I instantly looked photo ready. Like, let me see, from this little palette from the Ipsy box, I was shook. I don't use blush, but this will have me reconsidering because it's very cute. The highlight that I swatched, that's why I say swatches don't do justice. The highlight, I underestimated out of the highlight. And let me tell you, I blended this out because it was just too in my face. But I really like this as well. The Madison Miller Ofra blush trio, this bomb. What else? Now, let me look at my pamphlet because I don't remember. Favorite products from this Ipsy box for September was for sure the eyeshadow palette, the powder, and surprisingly that highlight and that trio. The pencil brush, when I first used it, I was like, yo, this is bomb. But honestly, has brow pomade under it. I just feel like it's not up to, it's really good. Don't get me wrong. It's good. It's like ColourPop standards. It's brow with standards, but my favorite brow pencil is precisely my brow. My favorite dip brow, Anastasia. But I feel like if nothing reaches my precisely my brow, then I don't want it. But overall, I am glad that I do have this Ipsy membership. Again, guys, if you're interested, it's only $25 a month. I know you might say only 25, but mind you, this is better than the $10 one because all products are full size. As you can see, they're all full size products. This is the only product I didn't use. This was a mask, but if you want, I can let you know my thoughts on this once I do try it. I will leave my thoughts on my IG or my Snapchat. If you follow me, you can keep up with me there. If not, I'll go ahead and link them down below. But overall, guys, this was fun, and like, I like doing these first impressions. What y'all think? I think my face looks bomb. That's what I think. And if in case you're wondering what lipstick I'm wearing, I'm not. I'm wearing a eye pencil from Urban Decay. It's a brown glittery one. Si te gustó, deja tu comentario abajo y avísame qué es lo que tú quieres que yo filme para ustedes. Like, déjame ver si es más maquillaje, si es review, si es algo para el cabello natural, de las pelucas, donde lo compro, cómo me lo instalo, lo que ustedes quieran, how I install my wigs, where I get my wigs from, makeup reviews, whatever you guys want, let me know, link it down below, and I gotcha. But yeah guys, this concludes the end of this video. I had so much fun filming this for you guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it as well. But God willing, I'll see you in my next video. Bye. Okay, so I came here in natural lighting. Okay, that was scary. All right, so I came here in natural lighting so you guys can see how the foundation looks. Yo, it looks bomb. You see, it doesn't look as light as my freaking video. I wish I had like a big window I could film in front of. But this is what the foundation looks like, and it's so smooth. Like, it looks like I have a filter. It's so buttery, like everything is so seamless. This is gonna be my go-to to go out. No, she is cute. So yeah guys, this concludes the end of this video. Thank you so much for watching, and God willing, I'll see you in my next video. Bye.